I spoke with Victor Mark in the car. I said that God believes in preservation. He preserves something he wants to multiply. So that is plan to preserve before dominion. So the first thing God do is to preserve something that he loves. So God doesn't play with preservation. Now the word of God, when he enters into a man, a woman, he preserves. He preserves. Now if you're here, you're a pastor. If the church must multiply, increase in strength, there should be impartation continuously in the soul of the people. I said there must be continuous impartation. Now you can, a soul that has enough light cannot depreciate in value. Let me say again, a soul that have can depreciate. Now in the last 10 years I've not taken drug. If I didn't take last 10 years, I will not take in 10 years to come. Because I didn't take when I was ignorant. Not when I can't take when I have come to knowledge. When I stumbled by faith, now I know why I can't take drugs. So I focus it. Once in a while, people try to invite me here to come and preach. I will look at them as I'm not that type of preacher. If you're looking for somebody who you want to preach in your church, you go look for people who do preaching. Not me. I don't know whether you're hearing what. People who do? No. You can't move me. I'm an ark. In my life, I don't want to eat food from several hands. In my lifetime. I don't want to eat. And I don't want to sleep in so many hotels in my lifetime. I don't want to be in so many countries. And I will never be. Somebody's looking at me now. I said, I don't want to be so many. No. So you don't tickle me by telling me God gave you ministerial open door to preach here, preach here. Don't be laughing. They invite me so many places. I'll just be laughing at them. I'm a pastor of immortal people. And I wouldn't want somebody to believe that it's something I'm looking for. I'm dead already. I will never leave. I was telling somebody today, I said, to God be glory that I am more of a spirit. And that is the only way I can be. So tonight, in a very short time, I want to be preaching on identifying with and transforming your bloodline. Identifying with and transforming. It is still under the heading building of ancient ruins. In case you are doubting where you are, Africa is a dilapidated continent. Africa is in ruins. Nigeria is in ruins. That is why it is one of the poorest countries in the world. Now we're going to look closely at what is bringing the ruins. So I want to talk about bloodline, identifying with and transforming. The word identify how to do it. Come, there is something about this bloodline, and that is recognized. When I was born, I knew, like I'm still here this night, this evening. There are two things I know that bother me. Number one, that I am an Igbo man, came from Southeast. It's a problem in my heart. Recognized, identify with. Number two, I am an African, a Nigerian. Number three, I am in a Gentile world. Now all these things I said are problematic identity. So Somebody didn't hear what I said. I said they are problematic identities. All this I've mentioned. Now what I've succeeded in doing is to recognize it and then keep fighting. What I've done most in my life is to somersault out of pit. I've been somersaulting since I was born, and tonight I have not stopped somersaulting. Somersaulting involves falling. Somersaulting out of pit to where I am standing is the reason I have not stopped. I have made a lot of mistakes in the somersault, but I have not stopped. So if you're here, you are falling, you have a chance to get up. I don't care what has happened. Life on earth provides opportunity for people to amend their ways and go on. Because falling is part of rising. I have had people who said since they were born, they're trying to paint a picture of perfection. I said that is falsehood. That is being spurious. A child that is born, that is growing, need to make mistakes, because the child have to be fallen as he grow. So mistake is part of learning. Bloodline. So I said every man on earth has an origin in a particular source. Let me say again, every man on earth has origin in a particular source, and God identifies us with that source. Let me say again, every man, every woman on earth has origin from a particular natural source, and God identifies us with that source. So, and God give us destiny in that source. Now, it is important for you to recognize your source. Number two, recognize a problem that is associated with that source. And then gradually, through effort, Holy Ghost empowered effort, grow out of that source. Excuse me. It is a blessing for a man to understand two things: the mistakes you've made, number two, your limitations. Mistakes that you made and you recognize and is willing to turn from it does not keep you down. That is why in chapter 5 of Revelation, Jesus is still bleeding tonight. Now that bleeding, he is bleeding, is a sign that there is something that is imperfect he died for. And then as he bleeds, he wins. That is why you don't play with sacrifice. So I said, God give every life destiny in its source. In 51 of the book of Isaiah 1 and 2, he said, you that want to stand right in God of Isaiah, he said, don't forget the rock from where you are wind. Don't forget your background. Don't forget who is your mother. Don't forget who is your father. Don't forget the sickness that run in that bloodline. Don't forget the evil that is obtainable in that bloodline. Don't also forget the advantages that is made available in that bloodline. He said you can't stand right if you don't recognize it. Am I saying something? Am I blessing somebody? Can we look at Isaiah chapter 8? It's popular sketch, but it's okay for us to look at it. Isaiah chapter 51. Now, please look here. Look, let me ask you to listen. It's a night of deliverance and freedom. A lot of people are dead on earth, wretched, frustrated. You see, because they play with their root. Somebody told them that if they are in Christ, all things are new, all things are passed away, and all things are becoming new. And they keep dreaming about this, a particular snake. They keep dreaming every night. And they keep on dreaming. mean about somebody who wants to choke them up. Now, when that person wants to choke them up, they wake up in the morning and said, old things has passed away. The person that wants to choke you up came from the new things. Or don't you know that every foundation has its limitation? Telling on those who came from that foundation. I have trained pastors for 25 years. Maybe I think you should listen to me. I have trained. And you know, I'm not married. So what I do more is that I live my life with pastors. With Locust Army, because I don't have another life. I don't have my wife. So I stay with them all the time. And because I am philosophical, everything you do around me makes meaning to me. If I'm in the car and you move your leg, I will start asking why you move your leg. I might not say it. Because my spirit was trained to be quiet. So foundations has their limitations, which need to be recognized and identified with. You don't play ostrich. You don't say it's not there. You don't fit it. You recognize it. Because this thing is binding on us. I don't know what that someone is. Huh? I'm trying to make bare sudden hidden truth. Now, if you look at Isaiah chapter 51, somebody go ahead and read Isaiah 51. I'm going to be fast because of time.
Hearken to me. Ye that follow after righteousness.
You that run after righteousness.
Ye that seek the Lord.
You that seek the Lord.
Look unto the rock. Hence ye are healed.
Look unto the rock where you are hid.
And to
hole of the pit from whence you are digged. Number two.
Look unto Abraham.
Your father, and unto Sarah.
That bear you.
For I called him alone.
And bless him and increase him.
The Bible said the word look unto is recognize. Identify with this source. From where you were hid, a particular source. Can I say something to somebody? The guardian angel of man's last destiny is an angel of infinite intelligence. And the angel of, that is why in chapter 10 of Revelation, that angel has a halo. And then the neck of the angel turned 360 degrees. Because that angel is God. So he sees, you know, in the realm of infinite intelligence, darkness and light is the same thing. I say, in the realm of infinite intelligence, darkness and light is the same thing. Death and life is the same thing. Now, it is a realm, in the realm of definite intelligence, confined intelligence, that men separate light from darkness. That is why when God wants to hide light, he hides it inside darkness, so that when you look at darkness, when you look at that darkness, you would know that light is there. So the more you look, the less you see. But in God, because of infinite intelligence of God, God knows that when you see darkness, you should look for light in it. Huh? That is why in every minimum, there is a maximum. To preach immortality, I have to come from where I came from, in a place of total darkness, because light is strongest in the place of total darkness. You don't use salad and fried chicken to please a small girl that was born in a rich home. But when somebody is born from a village and he sees chicken only once in Christmas, he perceives, I was born from a village where I eat rice only on Sundays. It didn't happen to some of us. You don't cook rice. As I was growing up, you don't cook rice in the house until it's done. That's the kind of place I grew. Did you grow from that kind of place? Now there are certain maximum destiny that God raises from such. Because every maximum disadvantage creates opportunity for maximum advantage. Let me say again. Every maximum disadvantage creates an opportunity for maximum advantage. Am I saying something? So God believe in your root, in the place you came from, and he will like you to identify with it. I said, source is not usually denied, but it can be transformed. Put down your paper. You don't deny it. That is why when people say we break that foundation, you don't break a foundation, you grow out of it. In chapter 11, please, can I ask you to look up? The work clock is before me and we have so much. I would like you to look up. Every foundation has a promise. And the earth is full of opportunity of change. That's my announcement. In chapter 11, 1, 2, 3 of the book of Isaiah, the Bible says, Lopete your chaperon, that out of Jesse, a stem came out. Jesus came out from Jesse. He didn't bind the problem of Jesse or the problem of Judah or David. He didn't waste his time because he has already grown out. But he recognized it. As I'm here in this altar, there are things I recognize, both positive and negative. There are influences. I search myself. Searching yourself is part of prosperity. I change every day because I know that I have to go on into brighter light. So I don't potato where I am. If I'm alive this night, it means there is something I must know this night before I come to church tomorrow. Living provide me with such chance. So I make books. Let me say again. I say living or life provide me with such chance. Now, every root has its destiny. Please hear me. I'm going to truncate into Christ as I round up. But before you start asking Christ to transform you, you should be able to know what is available in your root. In chapter 11, 1, 2, 3 of the book of Revelation, the root of David had seven spirits in promise. I said the root of David has seven spirits. That is a promise of that root. Now, if you want to marry a man, it is very important for you to discover the promise to their root. The characteristics of the bloodline is superior to love. Because whatever that is disadvantage, we diminish love. I don't know. Am I saying something? When the Lord said to me, excuse me, try and listen. When I preach immortality, people say, why are they talking about immortality? And they think that immortality is a free gift. Listen, I didn't say I can't die because God will keep me alive from heaven. There is a value in me that sustains the covenant. So I'm not going to say it is God that makes me immortal. And each time God, something want to touch that value, God will say to me that you will not die as conditions. And every great blessing has conditions. What is my heart tonight is for God to raise mighty people of this army. But if this army must be mighty, this army must be sacrificial. This army must give out things they don't need. They must go give to come into a new level. And hear me, giving is a life of kings because it takes great heart to make sacrifice. Wounded people and discouraged people don't make sacrifice. Weak people don't make sacrifice. Somebody, I thought you clap before I just said what. I say weak people, people that are mentally lethargic, they can't make sacrifice. You see, because they trust their life on the things that cannot even sustain them. I don't know what I'm saying something. So, in the root of Jesse, there is seven spirit there. And when Jesus came and was born, he harvested it because he saw it there. It is not God. It is Jesus didn't get seven spirit from heaven. He get it from root. He get it from the family. From the root of Jesse. Because it is there. He got it from the root. He was in the bloodline. It is not God that gave it to him. But something happened. All who identify with the vision of the bloodline process the bloodline. Time will not permit me to tell you about the procession know-how of a bloodline. The service came, spirit came out because it was processed. Can I say this before we read that, look at that scripture? When God, you know, our relationship with God is built on promises. A promise that we must harvest and process. I say we must. Hear me. It is a value, it is only valueless life that doesn't have what they look at. Those who are great have something they look at that must control their lives. As I'm here, there are things I look at, and as I look at them, I live from them. So when you give me counsel or suggestion, I go back to the mirror that hold my future to go and make inquiry. Now, sometimes people advise me against my guardian angel. I don't listen to them because they don't actually know me. Isaiah chapter 11, time is going away. Maybe you are here tonight and you're looking at me. I stand at the altar of life and immortality to say to you that sickness doesn't have what it takes to kill you. Men die only when they permit sickness to kill them. Whatever that took a man's life took permission from the man. Because your life is your life. If you don't lay it down, it can't be taken. Somebody didn't hear what I said. I said all that their life were taking, all men that their life were taking, laid it down. And then they took it. And every life is meant to be laid down. But people like us, when we lay down, we take. Some people lay down carelessly. In John chapter 10, 17, and 18, that's what Jesus said. Alright. In the book of Isaiah, chapter 11. Chapter 11, 1 and 2 and 3. Isaiah chapter 11, somebody help us read.
And there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse.
The Bible is saying, please listen. The Bible is saying, a particular rod will come from a particular source. And this is the nature of that rod because of the source. Like I need to tell you, every man that came from a background is controlled by the guardian angel of that background. Let me give you intelligence. Some people, when they grow up, they said that while they were growing, they were confused. The influence that is coming to you after birth is not stronger than the activity, is far less than the activity of your guardian angel. Every man that was born with a guardian spirit. Now, if that situation you saw yourself in is contrary to what was ordained, your guardian angel will fight it. Ordination is stronger than the problems you have. So if a problem came into your life, it's because ordination tolerated it. Did you hear what I said? And the reason why pastors compete and open churches everywhere, even when they know that they should be under a man, is because they believe that God will honor their strength. God doesn't honor strength, He honors ordination. So you can't surprise me. When I see the guardian angel of your life, I know where you will land. I don't know what I'm saying. Something. Am I saying something? Now, if you look at verse 2, he said, and the spirit shall
rest upon
him, and the spirit of wisdom and understanding, and the spirit of counsel and might and knowledge and
the fear of the Lord.
Seven spirit. In chapter 5, the Bible called them seven spirit. Hear me. Let me give you advice. No matter how mountainous a particular challenge is, every problem has its lifetime. Don't face a problem. Face your vision. Face your future. As you go closer to the light of vision, problems take care of themselves. Excuse me, when I was coming to Abuja, was I thinking of what I will eat? Was I thinking of what I will eat? Was I thinking of where I will sleep? When I came here, the man gave me three suits, and I was happy, gave me shoe. Today, somebody brought me three suits. That means what I have now is six since yesterday and today. So should I go to where they sell suits? Should I go to where they sell shoes? I don't know whether you're hearing me. As you look at vision, problems die. Great men don't face problems. They face their vision. And then they attend to immortality through vision. And then as they go closer to the light of vision, problems die. Somebody didn't hear what I said. Did you hear what I said? In Psalm 110, he said, the Lord said to my Lord, sit here until I make enemies footstool. Into he said, a rod shall come out of Zion. A rod. To fulfill that promise. Now when you hear Zion, Zion represents human being. Somebody will provide a rod that God will use to fight for him. Am I saying something? So I'm talking about identifying with and transforming your bloodline. I said we're all born to improve the story of our bloodline. Write it on your paper. If you're here, that is a challenge you have to make your children better, to make the story you met better. Am I saying something? Because every branch we eventually become a root. We were all born branches, but don't forget that branch we eventually turn to a root. When Jesus was born, he was born both branch and root. 22 of Revelation, he was born as offspring of David. In chapter 5, he was born as the root of David. And now that is a separation between the man Jesus and the Christ. The man Jesus came from the lineage of David in the bloodline, physical bloodline. But the man Christ came from the bloodline of God. The Christ, the incarnate Christ. Came from. So in Jesus is the coming together of two bloodlines. The bloodline of Jesus from the lineage of David and the bloodline of God from the lineage of God. As you're looking at me here, I tell you a secret. My strength is in the bloodline of God. If it's the bloodline where I came from physically, I would have stopped a long time. I have enough snake in my mother's story and my father's background to stop me. Enough snake, enough ordination, enough oath, libations, evil agreements, things that nobody talks about because the church don't go to deeps. The reason why pastors don't rise, the reason why pastors can't stop committing sin, why a pastor is a pastor, but he cannot overcome taking alcohol in the secret. when he's trying to overcome it, the bloodline speaks. Excuse me. When Jesus came to the earth, I don't know, should I be free? Huh? We are many here now, so how can I be free, mysteries? The strength Jesus had to accomplish was not Jesus' strength. It was Christ's strength. It was the influence of the bloodline of Christ that overtook the influence of Jesse's bloodline. But Jesse's bloodline was passed to be able to bear Christ. So what happened is to take that man, Christ, to Calvary, to make him submit to take that man, Jesus, to Calvary, to kill him, to be able to make him submit finally to Christ. So it was, I don't know what I should say this. It was at Calvary that the bloodline, that what follows the bloodline of David and Jesse, eventually was crucified. At Calvary. So Jesus had to go to Calvary to end an influence of a root. Now those who said there is nothing in that root are sinners. They are pastors that commit sin in the secret because they are covering their sin. If you cover sin, you won't prosper. So when those pastors pretend to all that nothing is wrong with them, then they are false. And Jesus said, when a man cover his sin, he will die in his sin. If Jesus go to Calvary to end up a weakness, I don't know, it's not, it didn't come out of my mouth, to come out a story that follows a bloodline. Why, who am I? Then I should go to Calvary to end my own. So if I have not gone to Calvary, don't look at me like that. I can still behave like someone who came from a particular bloodline that has a problem. I said, don't look at me that way. I can still behave like someone that came from my village. Sometimes. Somebody's looking at me. No, 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 do it. Nobody tells you the truth. Nobody tells you that truth. He said, Shepherd. Are you blessed tonight? Are you blessed tonight? Are you blessed tonight? Let me give you an answer. When Abraham came from the lineage of soothsayers, magicians, Chaldeans, in 11 of Genesis, there was hope. In 12, he built an altar. He understood sacrifice. That altar was the beginning of separation of a bloodline that has a problem. The beginning. Some of us that are here, you need to start a journey to destroy the influence of a bloodline that has a problem. The Bible said in 12 and 1, like vision, God said, this is what you will be, this is what you will be, this is what you will be, this is what you will be. I will bless you that, I will bless you this, I will bless you that. And then in 7 and 8, he made sacrifices. He continued. All those things that happened to Abraham were the things that bloodline produced. We are going to spend short time because of time this night to fight. Whether it is poverty or sickness, wherever the evil of bloodline speak in your life, the Lord will destroy it. I didn't hear an amen. I didn't hear an amen. He married in the story after some time because Sarah was barren. Sarah persuaded Abraham to go into Hagar, produce Ishmael, which is a today's problem. And then Assyria, that was not, Sarah was barren, bloodline. Isaac, his son, got married. Rachel became barren. Is it Rachel? Rebecca became barren. The bloodline, that thing, Abraham transferred it. Transferred it. I am opening your eyes to look into your mother. To look into your father. To look into your family. I recognize something that was transferred to you. certain negative sicknesses. Maybe you are here, you have sugar in the bloodline. Maybe certain, a lady came to me and said, Shepard, one of the reasons why I came to Lagos Army is because they told me my mother died at the age of 40. And the prophet told me that I came from that kind of bloodline influence. And they have told me that I must die at the age of 40. I said, that evil destiny cannot follow you because I will transfer you. But that is, she has already identified that there is a problem. I might say something. Now, after Isaac, Jacob married Rachel. Rachel became barren. Bloodline. A lot of sicknesses, sugar problem. People that lose their mind in seasons. Elated. Delays. This is runs in the bloodline. The bloodline of Judah. You know Judah's bloodline. You know a kind of story telling people that find it difficult to control the zip of their trouser. It's a great evil. You know zip. No, they can open it anyhow. Judah. Because Judah was opening the zip of the trouser anyhow. You know the story now. How he went and got that lady. Excuse me. You can't know the caricature of an old man giving a small girl a goat. I said, you will not know. You don't know the caricature of an old man like Judah giving a widow of his son goat. You wouldn't know that kind of weakness. That somebody gave birth to a boy, and the boy married and died, and his father went to lie down to the wife of his dead son. And then the girl said, since you don't have a goat, you got him something to before you go and get goat. Because Judah couldn't control his zip. It was a bloodline. Now I have met people that can zip up. Now I said, because Judah could not zip up, he didn't know when he carried everything and gave to the girl, and then went and brought goat, and then, you know, lie down with the girl. I told the girl, stay here. Can let me go and get the small goat. By the time she came there, the son's wife who played harlot disappeared, and then the girl got pregnant. Judah came out in the obese. I said, this is an abomination in Israel. There are people who are like that. He have an abomination where? He have an abomination in Israel. What a crime! Why? Dear one, question on you, Lucho. He's pregnant. What a crime! Why? He was shouting. The girl left her. When everybody got, you know the story. The girl said, if I am guilty, the person that have what I'm about to bring out. Excuse me. Was he different from David was walking on top of a roof? Was he different? Somebody say bloodline. Church, is it not a great night? Is it not a great night? Oh, come you shiri. Somebody that is in this place, your mother is in this meeting from grave. Your mother, somebody who is hearing me, your mother is in this place from grave, and she asked me to tell you that her grave is sinking. that her grave is sinking. As water is beating on that grave, the grave is sinking. She asked me to tell you to go back to the village and do something about that grave. She has worried me to tell you. I've been worrying me since about 10 minutes and I've told you already. Because you need that woman. She didn't die. If she died, she would not be here now. Well, that's not a conventional message. So I saw where angel, because she was prayerful. I saw where angels, she sently, I saw where angels are trying to lay stones on her grave to honor her. So don't allow angels to do for you what you should do. Now, God discovered that it's a negative. And so he brought Jesus. The Bible said, while we were dead, he quickened us. So Jesus, when you are born again, you are no longer running completely on the bloodline of ruins. You're supposed to function from the bloodline of Jesus. He quickened us to heavenly places where we are above family standard. If you're a child of God, you are above family standard. You are above whatever that will happen to a natural man. In chapter 3 of the book of John, the Bible says, whosoever that is from above is above all. The spirit of Christ in transfer of destiny lifts you above the limitations of bloodline. So in the book of Colossians chapter 1, he said, we are translated from the kingdom of the form of darkness into the kingdom of his son. There is a translation. There is a change of destiny. You are here tonight because your destiny needs to change. Am I saying something? I said because your destiny needs to change. Now, when you come into the consciousness of that change of destiny, every miracle will fall into place. Hear me. While I was young, I used to have fever once every 6 weeks to go and take injection. But through a spiritual and mental translation and impartation, I don't take injections anymore because change is possible. The greatest value on earth is the value that transformation provides. So tonight, all things are possible unto those who are in Christ, who first of all recognize where they came from and then give Jesus the sovereign place. Some people don't give Jesus sovereign place. Give him sovereign place through absolute surrender. Surrender everything and then a new story will emerge. I say a new story. Father, great strength is on me tonight, sent messenger, redeemed by the blood, to say to this army, everyone that is weak shall be made strong. I didn't hear an amen. Everyone that is subdued shall be quickened. As many as are veiled in nothingness, they shall be elevated. I prophesy change of your destiny. I can hear an amen. I prophesy the emergence of new glory. I prophesy resurrection. I prophesy the power of God in your life. I speak to your blood system the revelation of the arm of God. I say I speak into your life, to your foundation, a manifestation of the power of God. From this time and on, everything around you shall change. I can hear an amen. If you are in Christ, you are a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are new. If you believe that all things are new, shout a big amen. I didn't hear an amen. I didn't hear an amen. It's no longer that place you came from that matters. It's the spirit of Yahshua, the quickening ability of God. God said to Ezekiel, he said, Ezekiel, you go to dry bone, make prophecy. Please hear me. I am a preacher of faith. Totally. Sometimes people say, Shepherd, you have so much faith. I say, I will not have anything to that God. Not even 1 second. Do you know what it means? I have preached immortality for about 17 years. I've gone through thorn and thick processes. I've been the deep many times. People have said that is heresy. I see that the Bible is not with them. Sometimes people believe that it is only weakness that is available. It is only that is. So when they see men like I say, why is he saying that is different? I say, men can't be different. It's not where you are that matters. It's giving the future you see a place. The moment I preach a little while tomorrow, I saw in a vision where I took bread and I broke it with the hand of Christ and I gave men. And then I said, take and eat my flesh. The flesh of a king that is not in the grave. I don't care how religious you are. If it's about religion, I will not stand here. If it's about preaching into program and forget what I say and go home, now I won't be here. Now. But if it's that it's a life to live, a life to be kept down, then I will preach. And hear me. And then allow you to watch me. When I finish preaching, I will allow you. Yes. I believe that life should speak longer than words. As one said, thou excellent Theophilus, that this is what Jesus began to do. So he teach after if there's time. I had to tell my boss, I said, I live my life before you. When I pack into my house, I said, I'm not going to have a woman visitor. A woman visitor in that house all the days of my life. I told the boys, I said, any day a woman, you bring a woman there, that same day, you're going to get a new house, pay. Buy me everything I need. And then no. So if you something make you come very close to that house, they will start shouting. So one day I was asking them, I said, the people who are living around us, who knows that I've lived here for 2 years and no woman has entered there, did they say I'm an occultic man? I just asked them. One day a photographer came there to snap me inside the house, and he came with a lady companion that will help him. When he came at the gate, they told him, I said, this girl will help you, but he will not come inside Shepherd's house. He's going to help you in another place, not here. And I wasn't afraid of the photographer. Does your life have exemption? Every rich life has a do's and don'ts. If I see you and what you will not tolerate, I will know how far you will go. Can you lift your hand and thank God? Move your hand. Move your hand and thank God. Move your hand and thank God. Move your hand and thank God. Can you lift your hand and begin to talk in tongues a little while? Can you start talking in tongues a little while? Oh, my Father! My Father, my Father! My Father, my Father! Somebody talking to Satolo Rakaba! Zitolo Mama Satola Brashataya! Satolo Brana, he sent me! He sent me! He sent me! Kalala Baba Santo Brada! Legre Deleva, in the name of Jesus! While you're talking in tongues, begin to remove the roof up over your head. Remove the roof of limitation. Begin to say, every roof over my limitation, over my head, I remove you. I remove you that the rain of God might fall upon me. Every roof of limitation over my head. Listen to me, God will honor me this night. Please pay attention. One of the greatest virtues on earth is ability to pray. So if you have it, use it this night. I have a short time here. If you have that grace to pray, use it now. Use it before me. Now, if you don't have it, get it. Look at somebody and if somebody who is praying around you, pray. When we insist on a door, it will open. Now hear me. A day will come when I will still come to Abuja, and this program will be a world program. It will be a combination of Christians, politicians, world leaders, and I will still be here. The difference is that you will not be in this place. If this world falls to the ground, then what I have said this night is a lie. I will be helped. This church will be helped by God. This church will be helped by everything God created. I used an ordained voice. I used my ordained voice to talk to God. To say to God by the spirit of ordination that Villa will be helped after this night. I said, Locust Army shall be helped. My name is Chris, a shepherd of Locust Army, born to hate life and immortality. I said, this army will be helped. I said, your life will be helped. I didn't hear an amen. You shall be helped from God's presence. You shall be visited. Something unusual will take over your life. So can you say fire? Your limitations shall be broken down. An angel will meet you on the way. I say an angel will meet you on the way. Whatever that I have asked you, where is your God, shall disappear from your life. I say shall disappear from your life. Joblessness shall disappear. Going around the circle shall disappear. Family limitations shall disappear. They shall disappear by fire. They shall be disappear by fire. Shantolo Rakala Laba Shantala. I was sharing with the mark. I was kneeling down in Lagos Church praying for this program on Tuesday morning. They brought me a new angel. An angel came to me. I said to him, who are you? He said, well, I was sent by God to part of serving you. I have not been serving you, but I was recruited. I was newly recruited. Then I discovered that somebody prayed for me in a very unusual way. Somebody convinced God that Christian should go to another level. Somebody keep calling my name before God's throne. Maybe intercessors. And then they pushed that angel to me. On Tuesday morning, I was very happy. Now lift your hand and say with me, Lord Jesus, I receive grace to go to a new level. I tear down every limitation. Every going around myself. I destroy the circle system. I judge it by fire. If you can pray, go ahead and condemn it by fire. I condemn it by fire. I will never go around myself after now. If you are here, you know how to pray. You have to pray.
Yeah.
To your system and refuse to go in this program. That particular evil that believe that it cannot live your life, maybe it came from bloodline, that particular evil must go this night.
Amen.
Something that have kept your brothers down, something that kept your sisters down, something that you took from a fallen foundation, and an evil that functioned by oath and covenant must be forced out of that lineage. Say with me, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
By the anointing.
By the anointing.
Every particular evil.
Every particular evil.
Held me.
That held me.
Down.
Down.
For a long time.
For a long time.
Sustained in my life.
Sustained in my life.
By oath.
By oath.
Tonight in the name of Jesus.
Tonight in the name of Jesus.
I tear down.
I tear down.
Every oath.
Every oath.
Sustaining that evil.
Sustaining that evil.
And today in the name of Jesus.
And today in the name of Jesus.
I free myself from the evil.
I free myself from the evil.
Go ahead and break every oath.
I
break every oath. Sustain this evil.
Every oath.
I break every oath. Fire!
attack you.
Telling me, shepherd of Lucas army, I mean intelligent people, we know that is something in your heart, but if you come from that background where you come from, that this thing you're looking at will not be possible. They keep on telling me every day. I keep saying, Lord, it must happen, even though my background abhors it. I destroy the power of evil destiny. Lift your hand and say with me, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Tonight in the name of Jesus.
Tonight in the name of Jesus.
I shatter the power.
I shatter the power
of evil destiny.
Of evil destiny.
Can you go ahead and shatter the power of evil destiny? I take the blood of Jesus.
I take the blood of Jesus.
I go to where the agreement was made.
I go to where the agreement was made.
I scatter the agreement.
I scatter the agreement.
Can you go ahead and take the blood of Jesus and go to where they made the agreement?
Lord, I take the blood of Jesus.
I got the blood of Jesus.
I got the blood of Jesus.
I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of Jesus. I got the blood of
favor.
My father, oh my father.
I saw like in a vision. I saw in a vision a table of sorcery turning. Table of sorcery. You know, somebody was praying, then you landed where the ancients were making agreement. And then you subvert. Then you topple, then you change it, then you topple it. Then you turn the table upside down. Then you say it is over. Then you quench the voice. Then there are voices talking evil, speaking against us in the sun. Speaking, I vow to God. Some people who are here, there are things you don't have now. By the time you meet me again, if sweat has voice, and if I am shepherd of locusts, I may preach 25 years. Union. You can't meet me again. That way you are.
Amen.
I speak it under unction. I say you can't meet me that way you are now. By the time you set your eyes again on me, everything about you would have transformed. Of your person, we speak. I can't hear an amen. I say the power of your person shall speak. Wherever your enemies gather, they shall scatter immediately. Things that doesn't happen to your family people shall begin to happen to you. I didn't hear an amen. There is always a time God will change the story of a particular family. At the time of David, he changed the story. At the time of Jesus, he's changed the story. At your time, he will change the family story. Because you are an agent of change. Little Anna said, Lord, I am an agent of change.
Lord, I'm agent.
I turn the table of sorcery around me upside down. Can you go ahead and turn it upside down?
I turn the table of sorcery around me upside down. I turn the table of sorcery around me upside down. I turn the table of sorcery around me upside down. I turn the table of sorcery. I turn the table of sorcery. I turn it upside down. In the heavens of the earth, the table of sorcery. I turn the table of sorcery. I'm
Jesus. I need to tell you by God's grace that I have won many battles. I've won battles in cities. When I laid the foundation of Sulere Church and built to second floor, no, first floor gallery. One day I was sleeping there, waiting for Nive G to come. Right opposite that church, a demon threw a rope from the other side of the main road to the rod. When he threw the rope there, the rope caught up with one of the pillars in the church. And they were pulling it down. They said, we're going to pull this building down. You know, because we built that church under 16 months with fire. Street people were saying, is there war? I said, yes. Because I had to go to Lagos late. I like fighting. When they threw that rope and we're pulling it down, I look at the man and said, why are you pulling down the building? The man looked at me and said, you just came to Lagos. You can't share power with us. Then I know something is called sharing power in a city. If you're here, there is a place that when you have land in Abuja, they will believe that you are blessed. Where you have building in Abuja, they will believe, because they are sacred places of spirits. So people who does not do transaction, don't buy land in such place. Who doesn't understand spiritual transaction? Who don't take from giving? And then, because you know I'm winged, when the man said, you can't share power with us, then I told him, I said, I will teach you how to share power. I took my wind and then I was about to fly to where he is, and I woke up physically. I said, listen, I can't open my eyes. I can't. I closed back my eyes and I couldn't see anything again. I started cursing the man. I came from my father to advance him. The elders outside the church, some inside, some from your family, some from heaven, some came from grave. They are telling me to tell you that you must advance them. Your mother wanted to bring a testimony in the house. They wanted to build a fine house in that village. They wanted to make a road that enter into the family compound. They're going to say, Lord Jesus, tonight I turn the table of poverty upside down. Can I hear you turn the table of poverty upside down? The table of poverty, I turn the table of poverty upside down. 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 I turned upside down. I turned upside down. You know, some of us, the way that way you're looking at me, I know you're not used to prayer, and that is very bad. You can't open your mouth. I'm about to come down. You can't open your mouth. I'm sweating. Why can't you sweat? Is it evil? You can't pray that prayer that way. You can't pray that prayer, that cosmetics way you're praying that prayer. We're talking about something that touched your root, where you came from. You can't pray that prayer, that cosmetics. I will stay here beyond another 15, 20 minutes. So what is that? What is that? There's an attack. You can't pray that prayer. Listen, pastors, hear me. Praying grace is enough to take a ministry far. That thing that happened to your father can't happen to you. My biological father is in the grave. My spiritual father is in the grave. So if I don't fight, what take them is hanging around me every day. What took two of them, spiritual and physical? challenging my confession. I say every day they challenge my confession. Say, you temple of death, poverty and sickness, delay. My name is Chris Christian. I turn you upside down. Can I hear you pray that prayer? You have no power over me.
I turn you upside down.
I pray for you,
Father, you sickness.
You
sickness.
You table of poverty.
You
table
of
poverty.
You table of
poverty.
You table of poverty.
I turn you upside down.
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 Sickness.
You table of poverty.
You table of poverty. You have no power over me.
You table
of
sickness.
You have no power over me.
I turn
you upside down.
I turn you upside down.
I turn you upside down. I turn you upside down. I don't have sickness. I don't have sickness. You have no power over me. You have no power. You have no power. You have no power. You have no power. I don't have sickness. 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 I don't have sickness.
This prayer, you, if you're here, you've not gotten your own water, you can walk out quietly to go and get water at the stand. But if you have your water, you can keep it when I tell you to bring it. I'm going to take a prayer for another 5 minutes. You're going to say, Lord, whatever that have kept my brothers down will not keep me down. Where my brothers stop is where I will continue from. All these people who are going out, they didn't buy water. I thought I announced it. Say with me, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Where my brother stopped.
Where my brother stopped.
I fathered the family from there.
I fathered the family
from there. Can you not hear that? Father your family
from there. This
name shall come out of Jesus.
Where my brother stopped. Where my sister stopped. Where my father stopped. I fathered my family from there. I fathered my generation. I fathered my father's house. Where they stopped. I receive energy. Energy by the finished work of Calvary. The father. In my prayer. I'm not going to be able to do that. generation.
When I finish preaching, so the testimony time should be swapped over to the not before I come. I'm the one that will take testimonies of what happened during preparation, what happened during the program, what is going to happen this night as you go home, and what will happen here tomorrow in the morning. In the morning is body service. It's one of the things that make this altar unique. The Bible says, God in sundry times and diverse manners spake to our fathers by the prophets. Now he speaks by his son. Don't play with prophetic moment. Value is added to you. When I bless in that water, I bless that water. I'm going to do only one prayer. Then I will know that this night is gone. Open your water. When you open it, you will say with me, Lord Jesus, I stand before you. Before the God of life and immortality, and I declare before him that sickness and poverty,
will
not have power over me. That shame will not rule my life. That tonight, in the name of Jesus. By the blood of sacrifice. Every obstacle before me. Every sickness in my tissues. In hidden places of my body. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of God.
I command the life of those sicknesses. To be taken in the name of Jesus. Drink living water.
As I drink living water.
Let every contact. Every spell. That represent the devil. In me. Connecting me to the grave. Be broken. Every religious spirit. That make me familiar with God. Is condemned. By the strength of God. Every familiarity. With anointing. Is condemned. By fire. Even now. Showed me, Lord Jesus. This is the water of life. Can you lift it above your head and begin to receive power through it? you are inside or outside watching on the screen, lift up your water above your head. Father, it is in your presence that we are doing it. We do it by faith. Jesus is the water of life. This is the water of life. I release power into it. Begin to say, I receive power through it. I receive power. I receive power. I receive power. Have you said power? Come into this water. Bring life into it. Let me drink and be free from the spell of the enemy. As I drink now, I am free from the spell of the enemy. Every sickness that connects me to grave, let that sickness be condemned. I disallow the sickness in my body. I am healed. If you believe you are healed, shout fire. Go ahead and drink in God's presence. If you have my quantity, this type I have, you're going to finish your water. And when you're coming tomorrow, you're going to buy another one. Don't go home with it. Keep drinking it. Keep drinking it until it's exhausted. Except you have to. Oil as you're still standing, I will pray a prayer that makes me shepherd of locusts and I will know I'm done.